I came across a wonderful paper that uses data from three different telescopes to show some very interesting aspects of galaxies. For a dramatic effect, let's see how Alice and Bob, two astrophysicists, might respond to this paper. Alice understands that electricity is a major factor in creating and maintaining cosmic structure. Bob, on the other hand, sees only gravity as important. I will try to show that Alice finds the paper is no surprise to her models, and maybe is even kicking herself for not going out on a limb 5 years ago and publicly predicting all the results in the paper. In contrast, Bob will be shocked and will need to once again go back to his blackboard. So the key points. One, different wavelengths show different magnetic field orientations, like the coaxial sheath model predicts. Two, the energy balance agrees with a self-contained current system where thermal effects are minimal while the motions of the parts are held in place by electromagnetic fields. And three, the overall structure of the galaxy is what one would expect from a fractal torus geometry current flow. So the paper, Extragalactic Magnetism with SOFIA, a magnetically driven flow in the starburst ring of NGC 1097, by Enrique Lopez Rodriguez et al., 2021. Okay, it's a pretty hefty paper, and they use data from the SOFIA Airplane Telescope, from the Atacama Large Millimeter Array, ALMA, and from the Herschel Satellite Telescope. So I love this. It's observations from the ground, from the air, and from outer space. So here's two different views of the galaxy. First one combines ALMA data with Hubble, and it's from NRAO. And then the second one is from the Eris Very Large Telescope infrared camera, showing the galaxy in a different view. And what I want you to pay attention to is that ring. Like, there's that star-forming region. The ring of stars is what the paper was looking at primarily, the donut there. Okay, so the next image, figure 9 from the paper, and that was the figure that launched this whole little essay. It shows the orientation of the magnetic fields in that main ring, the main donut of the galaxy. And the different colors, different colored lines, are orientations of the magnetic field. And what's so striking here is that different wavelength observations give us different orientations of the magnetic field. I never saw this sort of data presented before, and it is exactly what the electric universe model of cosmic current flow would predict. Let's imagine what we would expect to see if the galaxy had a simple ring current flowing around in that region. If there were a simple ring current, we'd expect to see, what would we expect to see for the orientation of the magnetic fields? So a simple kind of non-electric universe answer is that we would see magnetic fields perpendicular to the ring of current flow. In the little drawing here, you can see that the current flow is in pink, and then you can see the gold magnetic field lines that wrap around perpendicular to that. But we know that in real life, plasma is not so simple, and there are layers of complexity which will spontaneously arise. So the next layer of complexity is the formation of what we call a coaxial counter-rotating plasma current sheath. The black and white sketch there, that's a drawing of the current flow in a cosmic plasma. It takes a little while to understand what's going on. Don Scott laid this on us several years ago, and he got the idea from Lundquist, who proposed it in the 1950s. And the figure shows, actually it's the flow of electric current and the direction of the magnetic fields. So that's part of this, is that the electric current flow and the magnetic fields are in the same direction. And this is sometimes called a field-aligned current flow. Okay, now whether or not a galactic plasma has an exactly minimum energy configuration, that's an open question. But we would expect to see aspects of this coaxial system. And you know, what's amazing is that this coaxial current flow system has been observed in the lab. It's been observed in galaxies, astrophysics. But most astronomers have never heard of them. So if there were a powerful ring current in the disk of the galaxy, then yeah, we'd expect to see magnetic fields, but it wouldn't be a simplistic kind of high school explanation. We would expect to see magnetic fields going in all different directions. And if you were standing back away, then these various directions will cancel each other when seen from a distance. And that fact has always made this measurement extremely difficult to make. But what's great about the paper from Lopez, Rodriguez, and team is that they use different wavelengths, which highlight different parts of that current structure. And it shows you that different parts of that current structure, the magnetic field is oriented differently as we move out from that central ring. So I don't yet know the details how to work it out, but it's something like this. We would say that the 89 micrometer and the 3.5 centimeter and the 6.2 centimeter emissions are coming from different regions in the plasma. Cosmic plasma segregates by molecular species, it segregates by energy, it segregates by function that it's performing. And we'll find something such as the inner 6.2 centimeter line is coming from high energy heavy molecules, for example, while the outer 89 micrometer line is coming from lower energy, lighter molecules. The coaxial current flows are there for a reason. And the different wavelength observations show us how to see the different layers of current flow. My overall point is that the electric universe model of coaxial current flow is demonstrated in this observation. So Alice is not surprised. And as I said, she probably even would say, I could have predicted that. But Bob is left scratching his head because there is no mainstream explanation for how this sort of result could be observed. Mainstream astronomers are playing catch up, while the EU astronomers, well, I was going to say already predicted it, but at least are not surprised. Okay, next part, the energetics. Another result of this paper, they said that the energy balance in the interstellar medium of the starburst ring shows that the magnetic field energy is in close equipartition with the turbulent kinetic energy. Both energies are a factor of 10 higher than the thermal energy. These results imply that the starburst ring is magnetically critical, where the clouds are supported against the gravitational collapse. Okay, I would offer a different interpretation. When you're distinguishing between thermal motion and turbulent motion, what they're really distinguishing, what they're really pulling apart, is the difference between thermal motion and directed current flow. So this is a problem in categorization, and it goes all the way back to the belief that the cosmos around us is chaotic and thermal and unstructured and meaningless. Okay. So since mainstream cannot believe that there would be a purposeful motion, structured motion, of the matter in the galaxy, then they have to divide all the motion into thermal and non-thermal, or thermal and turbulent. Good luck understanding that distinction. And all of this actually simplifies when you accept that the motion in the galaxy is directed and purposeful, just like in cells in our bodies. Most of the motion in the cells of our bodies is directed and purposeful. A small amount of the motion of the molecules in our cells is thermal or chaotic, which means that the structures in the galaxy are moving in coherent ways and the magnetic fields are holding things in place. In other words, the galaxy is not random and chaotic. It's highly structured with complex movements, which are taking place at many different distance scales. The fact that motion is happening in many different distance scales, that's why the mathematics of turbulence lets you analyze it. You can apply that math of turbulence to analyze motion that's happening at large scale, medium scale, small scale, but that doesn't mean that the motions are chaotic. It just means that was the model you used to look at it. So if anyone has time, get a hold of me and we'll try putting in the full Carlquist relation to the data. I won't go into it now. We can just put it up on the screen. And we can see if we can tease apart some of the currents that are implied by these observations. Okay, lastly, Let's look at the overall structure of what we're learning about galaxies and how it fits more into Alice's electrical model and not so much anymore into Bob's gravitational model. The more data we collect on galactic structure, the more we see the signatures of fractal toroidal current flow, basic structure of a plasma torus. Torus is like a donut, and when you have plasma circulating in a torus, that also involves other structures, other current flow is naturally a part of that. A couple images here from a paper by Kollek called The Engineering Physics of an Optimized Confinement Concept. Kollek's work is great. It's hard to find. It's yet another example of a successful Lenner group whose work got buried or killed or something. We keep moving on, right? They can't kill all of us, can they? So fractal toroids means something like the next set of diagrams. The first one is just the simple overall structure. You have current flowing in a ring, that's that black ring, and then the magnetic field is the blue rings around it. But that structure in and of itself will naturally break up into a substructure, a fractal structure, where now you have a bunch of current flows that are flowing perpendicular to that original one. And then you have new complex magnetic fields, but then those will break up. And so you can see how the structure becomes more and more complicated. And that's a natural result or process of electric flow through plasmas. So if we were Alice, we would expect that as we dive into more galactic structure, we will see this kind of structure within structure within structure, and there will be these right angles to each other. Some structures will be at right angles to other ones, or maybe more better said, a large structure will be at right angles to the smaller substructures that make it up. So with that in mind, look at some of these images from MeerKAT, the radio telescope in South Africa, which is putting out some really great stuff. And you can see it's just wild, right? That's the center of our galaxy. And we're looking at radio emissions. So a lot of those emissions are going to be synchrotron radiation. But let me just back up. Most of those emissions you're seeing are from current flow. Some of them are thermal, but roughly 90% of the signal is coming from current flow. And you can see what I was saying, that you have these large structures that go in one direction and then smaller structures that are going around it or perpendicular. And you know, this data keeps coming in. It's all very exciting. This is a wonderful use of multi-wavelength astronomy. So kudos to Rodriguez. And all of it supports the EU models. The galaxy is a complex, coherent structure. And those electric current flows, they're going to be organic. They're not going to be like a simple classroom experiment. But they will show attributes of what the electric universe models predict. Thank you.